My name is Kapil Bharti. I'm a principal investigator at the National Eye Institute, National Institutes of Health. At NEI, I'm in a branch called Ophthalmic Genetics and Visual Functions branch. We focus on all kind of retinal degeneration diseases that affect people of from childhood to adult onset. So AMD focuses for the cell therapy project that we're working on and also for some of the disease modeling, but my lab and in our branch we also work on many pediatric early onset genetic diseases that affect the eye. Stem cells, particularly iPS cells, are really in the center of fight for us. They can be used as a cell therapy, and the other, they can be used to develop new drugs. And we're using iPS cells for both these purposes, to try and bring a treatment for AMD for patients affected with it. Specifically for cell therapy, what we're trying to do is to develop an autologous iPS-based retinal pigment epithelium patch for these people. So retinal pigment epithelium is a layer of cells in the back of our eyes that provides nutrients and functional support to the retina. So in AMD patients, this layer degenerates, dies off, and hence, because of that, the retina starts to die. So what we have done is we have created pigment epithelium as a patch from patient-specific iPS cells and have developed methods to deliver it back to the patient's eye. The cell therapy approach is to make iPS cells from patients, AMD patients, make the patch and bring it back to the back of the eye with the hope that it will continue supporting the eye, and patients' vision will be restored or at least won't deteriorate further. The process of making the patch takes about almost 6 months from the day we enroll the patient all the way to the final product. And so we have mapped out the whole process of making this patch. First making iPS cells from patient blood, banking them, and then from iPS cells going into making pigment epithelium, and then making a patch from that. The patch is basically pigment epithelium cells as a monolayer on a biodegradable scaffold. That's the 4x2mm patch, which covers more than half of back of the patient's central portion of the retina. And that's how it's supposed to be delivered and hopefully provide protection in that central portion of the retina. The advantage of using that construct is that there are conditions where actually, because of RPE loss in the eye, the vascular network in the back of the eye dies off. So this tissue, this construct would actually replace both of them. And then it also provides an in vitro model how to study macular degeneration in a dish. So we're also using it for that purposes, where you can test new drugs or toxicity of drugs. So there are ways, now we're kind of branching out from this existing technology to kind of bring the next generation of products. So my relationship with CDI Fujifilm started off almost 2 years ago when we contracted with them. The CDI Fujifilms have successfully delivered what they promised in that contract in terms of making that protocol robust enough, xeno-free, and compatible with GLP and GMP manufacturing. We're working very closely on HLA matched iPS cell lines on perhaps a second generation scaffold. I'm excited to work in the iPS cell field because I think this field has a lot of promise. For me, the most important thing this field brings is that we have the opportunity for the first time to work directly with patient material. Human material, patient material in a dish, to be able to uncover all the genetics, how the patient genetics affect the disease in a dish, and to also bring a patient-specific cell therapy products back. I think this possibility never existed before. It was really the discovery of iPS cells is what brought it in. I think this technology has huge potential, and I'm excited to be working on this technology.